While the Chinese coronavirus continues to spread around the globe, infecting millions of people, the Chinese government has ramped up their efforts to hide the truth. By now, many of you are aware of China's efforts to absolve themselves of any blame on the global stage, while at the same time working to secretly steal American medical research so they can take credit for finding the cure for the virus. But these efforts from the Chinese Communist Party are nothing new. We've been covering for years at the Leadership Institute's Campus Reform how China has been viewing American college campuses as soft targets for their propaganda efforts and how they've been stealing sensitive research and other information from our college campuses for years. Oftentimes, they revert to secretly paying off professors in exchange for sensitive information and research, while at the same time using Chinese exchange students as a form of spies so they can smuggle information back from American campuses to the Chinese Communist Party. Now, the Chinese government has denied all of these allegations and said that they're misunderstood and that they're simply trying to help spread research around the world and that their intentions are pure. Others here in America have said it's a conspiracy theory to try and question Chinese efforts on our college campuses and that it's politically incorrect to question the presence of Chinese-funded professors on our college campuses. Just in the past year, multiple professors and students have been arrested and charged with working secretly with the Chinese government. So we're going to go through a few of those cases right now and let you, the viewer, make up your own mind on what you think about these cases. First up, we've got Yi Qi Shi. Now, Yi Qi Shi was an engineering professor at UCLA. That was before he was caught smuggling sensitive military information to the Chinese government. According to the authorities, the information he stole had to do with Naval and Air Force missile technology. You know, casual, normal things that you hack into a computer to put onto a flash drive to smuggle to a communist regime. I'm sure there's nothing to see here. Now, Mr. Xi faces 219 years in prison for his espionage efforts. Next up is Charles Lieber. Mr. Lieber was not just employed by Harvard, he was the head of the entire chemistry department at Harvard University. This guy was a big deal. Now, Mr. Lieber was not only employed by Harvard, it turns out he was also employed by the Chinese government. He was paid in excess of $1 million to help build medical research facilities and other labs in the Chinese mainland. Now, in addition to the other payments, he was also given $1.5 million to help construct a medical research facility in, drumroll please, Wuhan, China. Yes, that Wuhan, China. Now, in addition to the monthly payments he was receiving, which were up to $50,000 a month from the Chinese government for these efforts, he was also given $150,000 from the Wuhan Institute of Technology. He just happened to forget to report that money to US intelligence officials when he was asked and lied multiple times under oath about whether or not he was working with the Chinese government. Mr. Lieber now faces 5 years in prison for lying to federal authorities in the intelligence community. Staying at Harvard, this is Zhaozong Zhang, who was a medical student at Harvard University. He was caught at Logan International Airport with normal things in his suitcase, clothing, socks, shirts, maybe some shoes, and 21 vials of American cancer research. He says it was out of the goodness of his heart that he was trying to share this research with the world to help people. American intelligence say that he was actually working with the Chinese government to smuggle that American-funded research out to the Chinese authorities who he'd been communicating with previously. Mr. Zhang now faces over 30 years in prison if found guilty on all charges. Next up, we've got Feng Tao, a professor at the University of Kansas. Mr. Tao was able to secure 4 contracts with the National Science Foundation and 2 more contracts with the US Department of Energy. Now, the entire time that he was conducting this research and being paid by US taxpayers, he also happened to secretly be working for the Chinese government and a Chinese university. He now faces 50 plus years in prison and a $1 million fine for his efforts. This man is Simon Ong. Ong was a professor at the University of Arkansas who was arrested and just last week charged with secretly working with the Chinese government and failing to disclose his ties. Now, all of this was going on while he was in the process of securing a federal research grant from NASA. According to the US Attorney's Office, Ong, quote, made materially false representations to NASA and the University of Arkansas, which resulted in numerous wires to be sent and received that facilitated Ong's scheme to defraud. Because of his secret work with the Chinese government and attempting to secure grants from NASA while doing that, he now faces 20 years in federal prison. Now, another professor who committed a similar crime, lying about their ties to the Chinese government while applying for grants from NASA, is this man, Omning Hu. Mr. Hu is facing 3 counts of wire fraud, as well as 3 counts of giving false statements after a grand jury found that he intentionally misled about his ties to the Chinese government while conducting 3D printing and nanoparticle research with U.S. federal grants. He now faces 20 years in prison and $250,000 in fines for his efforts. All of these cases have happened in the past year alone, and these are just some of the cases that we've reported on at Campus Reform. It's clear that China is doing everything in their power to exploit American college campuses and American research for their own gain, and it will continue until something is done to stop it. That's why we're committed at campusreform.org to exposing what China is doing and shining a light on their efforts to infiltrate our college campuses. You can head over to campusreform.org/China to read about all of their latest efforts to infiltrate our college campuses. And as always, send any relevant tips to contact@campusreform.org. I'm Cabot Phillips, Editor-in-Chief with Leadership Institute's Campus Reform. Thanks for watching.
Thanks so much for watching. If you want to join our team, we're always looking for new investigators, correspondents, and tipsters. Click right here to learn more about that. If you want to donate to help us make more videos like the one you just saw, click that button there. And if you want to be among the first person to see all of our new content, click that subscribe button right over there. Thanks so much.